the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Today we hear those wonderful words that God spoke to Jeremiah the prophet. Before I formed you in the womb, I loved you, I knew you, and before you were born, I consecrated you. And then the psalm picks up that same theme and says, I have been sustained by you ever since I was born. From my mother's womb, you have given me strength. My praise shall always be of you. God knew what Jeremiah had to do. And God knows what we have had to do. And he knew us all the way when we were in our mother's womb. We can all give praise to God that our mother didn't choose to abort us. Because his plan is going to happen, and he makes it happen. He sets us out to do what he asks us to do. What does he ask us to do? Well, at the beginning of this ceremony, we read the words of the Lord. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your mind, all your soul, and love your neighbor as yourself. These are the two commandments. That's what we have to do. Now, Paul gives us practical explanations of what that means. What does it mean to love? What does it mean to love? And this poem that he wrote, the love poem from 1 Corinthians, is so neat. And sometimes, at least I have read through it, and you just go bing, 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 all over those words, and they just seem to slide together. And I think it's sometimes good to step back, and we're going to do that in a minute, and look at each one of them individually. What does that mean? For instance, love is patient. What does that mean? Well, there's all kinds of times when we get upset, frustrated, whatever, and we go, brrr. He says, be patient. Be patient. Because love calls for patience. Love is kind. Well, we know what that means. We can do kindness every turn. Love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. I sometimes see people in the restaurant, as an example, who think that the waitress or waiter who comes to the table is their servant, and I don't see them treating that person as a person. That person is just like we are. That person has cares, probably carrying a heavier burden than any of us are carrying, and need kindness, and need love, and need respect. And I don't see that sometimes. I think I see rudeness sometimes. I say, no, love does not be rude. Love is kind to that person. Love asks that person, what's your name? And call that person by the name, because that's a person loved by God, created by God. Love does that. It does not insist on its own way. Think about a little bitty spat that we're in. What difference does it make that even we say that we're wrong? What difference, what does that have to do with my salvation? Absolutely nothing. So we get all upset and pound our fist because we are right. Not worth it. Not worth the effort. It's not irritable or resentful. I mean, that's a corollary to that first one. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. I think about the thing that really bothers me about some of the universities these days. They have this mindset that only this philosophy and only this way is to be heard. Anybody coming and telling us something different is to be ejected or booed down or out of this place. Don't even want to hear it. Well, that's not what a university is. University is a sharing of all ideas, even the things that we don't think we like. I think of Paul. Paul went into Athens. And he was talking to these people about the craziest thing. Jesus didn't stay dead. He rose from the dead. And they said, what? What babble is this guy talking about? And they didn't eject him. They said, come on in. We want to hear more. They're open to this. Open to this new idea. That's what a university ought to be. It says, it rejoices in the truth. Well, find the truth. Truth is all over the place. It might be different from the thing we call truth now. Let's look at it. With an open mind. It bears all things. Sometimes we have a lot to bear. And he just says, bear it. We'll handle that. We'll take care of it. This one is kind of strange, believes all things. Well, that doesn't mean we have to believe that the Martians have landed. We don't have to believe some silly things, but believe all things, meaning all the things that we hear about Jesus in the scriptures, for instance, that's what we believe, and believe them all. It hopes all things. That's our hope, that all that Jesus said will come true, that someday we will have that place where we will be with him. He will come back to take us with him. That's where we will be. That's the hope we have. It's not a hope that, gee, I hope. No, it's a hope of assurance that this will happen, and it's an anxious kind of hope. Let it happen, Lord. Let it happen, because it's going to happen. Endures all things. And then love never ends. Never ends. It's there all the time. But when we will, then it goes on, we will then see face to face. And now I know only in part, but then I shall know fully, even as I am fully known. That's what we're hoping for, to be fully known. In our colic this morning, we asked the Lord, in our time, grant us your peace. Right now, in our time, grant us your peace. And a neat part about that also comes from Paul. Paul says this in Romans, bless those who persecute you, bless and do not curse them. Rejoice with those who rejoice, weep with those who weep, live in harmony with one another. Do not be haughty, but associate with the lowly. Do not claim to be wiser than you are. Do not repay anyone evil for evil, but take thought for what is noble in the sight of all. And then here's the big punchline. If it is possible, so far as it depends on you, live peaceably with all. I think that's a clue. As far as it depends upon you. And that's a pointing finger from Jesus right to each one of us. It depends upon you. You cannot change anybody else's thoughts. You cannot change anybody else's actions. The only person we can change actions and thoughts about is ourselves. And if it depends upon me, then I will live peaceably with all. I have control over that. I can control that. I can live peaceably with all. I don't have to be right. I can just be loving. I don't have to be arrogant. I don't have to be rude. I just have to be loving. Faith, hope, and love. These three. But the greatest is love.